After the simple failover video, a couple of people pointed out that the configuration won't be useful if you receive your ISP addresses through DHCP, and realistically, that is the case with most ISPs. So we're going to fix that now. We still have the same setup with our router and two ISP gateways, but the gateways are now running DHCP servers. I removed the static IP and route configuration from our router, so we need to apply our configuration anew. If you want your default routes to ping the gateways, the DHCP clients have the check gateway parameter. It is pretty self-explanatory. You can set that up very easily yourself. What you probably want to see is how to apply the recursive routing hack, where we perform a check gateway against an always online IP such as Google or Cloudflare DNS. And that is how we determine if the primary ISP is operational. In the route section, we will want to again add a primary default route that wants to use Google as a gateway, exactly as before, with the check gateway parameter set to ping and target scope set to 15. Then we want this route to recursively lead to the ISP 1 gateway. You do have to figure out the IP address of that gateway somehow. If you already had a DHCP client running, it would have dynamically added a default route using the correct IP, so you could have learned it that way. For me, it is the same gateway IP as the other video, so this route will again be the same as in that case. With the scope set to 10, the recursive routing will be able to take place here. That is all we have to do with static routes. Next, we need our DHCP clients. For ISP1, we want the client running on the respective interface, but the add default route parameter has to be set to no because we already have it. For the ISP2, just add the client as usual, but set the default route distance to 2 so that it is of lower priority. That's it. Now the routes should look something like this. Two default routes. Primary should be active and pointing to Google as the gateway, but recursively find the next hop correctly through the recursive route. The secondary default route should have been dynamically added for ISP2, and currently it should not be active. If we then break our ISP1 connection, the gateway check pinging Google DNS should fail. A brief moment later, when we look at the routes again, we should see the default route for ISP2 has become the active one. Just like that, four lines of configuration and you have yourself a simple failover with DHCP clients.